Hi and welcome to another video from TMS. Today I would like to introduce you to TMS Remote DB. In particular, I want to show you how to build database applications using TMS Remote DB. The outline of this video is as follows. First of all, I'm going to give you a brief overview what Remote DB is, and I'm going to jump right into showing a demo without Remote DB and then with Remote DB. At the end of this video, you will have the toolset to migrate existing VCL database applications to full-blown three-tier database applications. Furthermore, you'll know the advantages and you'll know why you're doing the things they're doing. This video will make certain that you know why you use Remote DB and what other options are, also from the TMS business set, if you're thinking long-term. So let's get right into it. What is Remote DB? As already said, Remote DB is the best solution to build three-tier database applications quickly in order to execute SQL statements through an HTTP server. The HTTP server is built on top of another product from the TMS business suite, namely TMS Sparkle. The most important thing to remember is that Remote DB is optimized for performance, stability, and easy migration for existing VCL applications to three-tier VCL applications. So this being said, if you're building a whole new infrastructure and a whole new database application, you should look at TMS Business X Data as well. However, if you already have a VCL application, then Remote DB is the way to go at first. Because let's be real, your customer will want a solution quickly, and Remote DB will deliver a solution where you can exchange existing components with Remote DB components, and you will be able to migrate your existing desktop application to a three-tier VCL application. I've been talking a lot about three-tier and database applications, so let's go step by step what it means to have a VCL database application and what the advantages are if you use Remote DB, and furthermore, why to use Remote DB first and then transfer your existing applications maybe to web services using X Data, and why Remote DB makes sense to be the interim solution, not the long-term solution, but the interim solution, so that your customers stay happy, can use your product, and you get yourself more time to maybe transfer to a web application using X Data as the backend. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let's do this step by step, starting with a database app, like you've been building it with Delphi 1, Delphi 2, Delphi 3, and so on, and what the disadvantages are of that approach, and then we'll build another database application using Remote DB. So for this whole video, I'll be using Red Studio 10.3, and we'll start, as explained, with a standard Windows VCL application. We're not even going to use data modules. We're going to drop all the components on a form. And even if this may sound a little bit ridiculous at first, but over 20 years using Delphi has taught me one thing. People like dropping things on forms. In order to not complicate this demo, I'm going to do the very same thing. So in order to have a database application, the first thing you need is the Fire Deck connection, right? In order to connect to your Fire Deck database. So we drop the Fire Deck connection, we double click it, and then we can select the driver. For example, Microsoft SQL Server. And then we can specify the database, the username, the password, something that we're used to with Delphi for years and years. I already prepared a connection called Lee Schools, which connects to a database which lists all the schools in Lee County. This is my server called Holston Desktop, and I'm going to use operating system authentication, so I don't need to specify username and password. We test the connection. Okay, it's established. Okay, okay. And the most important thing, disable the login prompt. So with that done, we drop a query. And the query is going to select star or asterisk from schools. We execute and we see that we get a result set. We click OK. And now we connect the user interface to the database using a data source, which is the T data source. And of course, we need a grid, TDB grid. We drop the TDB grid on the form. And to make it neat, we use anchors, right bottom. And the data source has to be connected to the data set, which is, of course, the query. And the grid has to be connected to the data source. Perfect. That's almost all we have to do. We click the form, and in the event that the form is being shown, we open the query. So we set active to true. That's usually all we need to do in Delphi to write a database application. Let's see if that's the case. Yes, this works perfectly as expected. We have all our schools extracted from the Microsoft SQL database. So what's the downside here? The downside is pretty simple. As soon as we have customers with different databases. So what you need to do then is you would have to edit your connection. You would have to work with different connection strings. However, your database would always be part of your application. You know, even if you transferred everything into a data module, you would end up with an exe file, but this exe would always depend on your database drivers, on the database connectivity. Your application would depend on the database framework that you used. And this is exactly where the new infrastructure comes in, that is known as the three-tier architecture. You would separate your application, namely your VCL exe file, from your database. How do you do that? That's simple. You basically get rid of the connection and get rid of the query. You make the query and the connection something that can be exchanged for any database that you want to use. And this is exactly what RemoteDB does. So with regard to terminology, this application serves both as the server and the client. You connect to your database server, but the application doesn't have the functionality of a client or a server. The application has both. The application is all-knowing. It knows all the functionality of your server and your client. This is why this VCL application needs to know which database you use. It needs to know about all the database drivers. So as soon as, for example, there's an update to the database, your application needs to be updated. And this is the major downside. Let's say you have a database update and you just update your server application. You don't need to do anything to your client applications. So all the people using or having access to your database don't need any updates. And that's the giant advantage of using a three-tier architecture. So let's migrate this example to a three-tier database application using RemoteDB. Building a RemoteDB server has become really easy because we have a new wizard. And we find this wizard in File, New, Other, TMS RemoteDB, and here you see a TMS RemoteDB VCL server. For legacy purposes, the old RemoteDB server application can still be found in the TMS Business tab, but we are going to use the new TMS RemoteDB VCL server wizard. So this creates an application, a VCL application, that serves as the server. Be aware that this is your server, which connects to any database that you want to connect to. Let's say you have two different customers. One customer uses Oracle, the other customer uses Microsoft SQL. So you would deliver the Microsoft SQL server to the one customer, and you would deliver the Oracle server to the other customer. However, the application that uses your RemoteDB server would be the same. That means you deliver the same client to every customer, no matter which database that customer uses. That is the big advantage. The only thing you need to do is you need to provide a special server for all your customers, depending on which database they use. Getting back to our example, we go to unit one, and you'll see that we have the remote DB server, which answers to a certain base URL. I'm going to change this base URL to port 80/flix. This is where my remote DB server will answer, meaning localhost port 80/flix. Just as we did with the VCL application, we are going to provide a FireDeck connection. We double click the FireDeck connection, and just as we did before, we set the same settings. We test it, it works, good, okay. And just as before, we take away the login prompt. The only thing we need to do now is we need to connect the connection, which is called the Aurelius connection, to the existing data access component. So as the adapted connection, we pick FD connection one. And this system is so smart that it recognizes it's FireDeck, Microsoft SQL. Okay. And the remote DB server is already connected to all these other components. So you don't have to pay any attention to this. This is all it takes to get a running remote DB server. After saving, I have my server.exe and I can run it. Perfect. Now my remote DB server is running and it provides access to the Microsoft SQL database that I specified in my FireDeck connection.
Let's build the VCL remote DB client application.
What we'll do is we add a new project to the project group. And this time we're going to pick a standard Delphi VCL Windows application. I named the application client.exe. The form will contain the same elements as before. We'll drop a DB grid and we'll anchor it just as before. So how do we work out the data connectivity this time? We need some sort of connection. And of course, we need some sort of query and we need a data source. So the data source will actually stay the same thing. We select a T data source and the grid will be connected to the T data source. That's all ready and done. So if you type remote in your component palette, you find that we have the remote DB database and the remote DB server. We need a database because the server is the other side. The database is representing the FireDeck connection. So what you do here is you specify the server URI or URL, and this is localhost port 80/flix. You can press enter, and the username and password is already filled in with the default values. So how do we specify the query? Well, if you have a look in the remote DB category, you find that there's a TX dataset. The reason that the name doesn't contain any remote is that you can easily replace your T datasets in all your existing VCL applications with X dataset. This makes migration really, really easy. So the X dataset is actually the replacement for the T dataset. You have to specify the database, of course. And here you find the SQL statement. So just like with a FireDeck query, you say select star from schools. Make sure that you set the data source to the data set. And now the final thing to do is, of course, you need to open the data set. I'm going to rename it to X data set. And we do the same thing like before, we use the form show event. xDataset.active and set it to true. That's it. And after running the application, you see that we get the data again. So let's look at the design time view one more time. Our main form has a data source, which is not database dependent. We have a remote DB database, not database dependent. And we have an X dataset, yet again, not database dependent. So this is exactly the reason why you're doing it. There's nothing from Microsoft SQL Server in your client.exe. The only thing that points to your Microsoft database is the server.exe. If you want your customers to be flexible which database to use, this is exactly what you want to do. You build your client with RemoteDB database and X datasets, and you have different servers for different database types. So this is not all what RemoteDB can do, because you can also edit these things. The only thing you need to pay attention to if you want to edit, you need to specify key fields that uniquely identify your records. If you look into the dataset that I just showed you, you find the object ID. This is basically the attribute that identifies every record. So I'm going to type object ID as a key field. And of course, I'm going to say auto apply, which means all the changes that the user makes in the grid are automatically applied to the database. So rerun this application. And let's make some changes. Let's say the Bonita Springs Middle School becomes the Bonita Springs High School. And you see, just like you lose from the VCL, we are in edit mode. We leave edit mode. And guess what? It's already applied to the data set. Let's close the application, restart the application. And here you see, it's still the Bonita Springs High School. Let's correct it again, middle school. So RemoteDB generates the SQL for you and sends it through its own server, and the server sends it through the database. All database, as it's formally called, database agnostic, meaning you don't have to care about anything in your client, which database you're using. RemoteDB is going to do that for you. So yet again, if you have a customer that wants to use Oracle, you write your Oracle server. If you have a customer that wants to use Microsoft SQL, you write a server for Microsoft SQL. The same goes for any database that FireDAG supports. And of course, RemoteDB supports many other databases. You can look those up in the documentation. So hopefully this introduction to RemoteDB showed you how useful this tool is to have in your toolbox. In the Delphi world, there's no better tool to migrate database applications written in the VCL to a multi-layer database application. So be sure to check out TMS RemoteDB.